Hi Sparrows, myself I am Sri Lakshmi Prasanna Sparrow from District Pedapalli and Garrapalli. So before going to topic, I want to say you something that by human birth, he created himself how to survive. So when the days are passing, the technology was improved. So when the technology was improved, all the works are done by the electricity. So where does, my question is that, where does the electricity comes from? So for that also, he created himself, the energy comes, the electricity comes from the energy. So today I want to go, today I want to sell that, how can we make energy remain sustainable? So so the energies are categorized into three types. They are fossil fuels, nuclear resources and renewable resources. So during ancient time, they used woods and timber and some of the waste products to produce their own energy. So when the technology was improved, the coal and oil were improved. So when these are used extensively across the globe, it leads to global warming. So because some of the pollutants are releasing to our atmosphere, so that's why it leads to global warming. So some of our researchers look at these issues and they think over to overcome this. And also they think that which resources can be replenished easily and also which resources can be reduced those pollution. So in that time the sustainable came into the picture. So the sustainable has two key points. They are renewable resources and energy efficiency. So while using this technology, we have some of the pollutants are increasing. And also it leads to global warming. So how the CO2 levels was from ancient days to till recent year. So let's see this graph. Are you observing that graph? So the increasing level of CO2 in depleting of the ozone layer. So the first graph is indicating some of the representations of the lines. So from 1900 to 2010, the increasing level of CO2 will be increasing year by year. For this will be surveyed by for every 10 years. And also see another graph. The blue mark is indicating that the whole year, which means the area of the whole of the ozone layer, and the red mark is indicating that the consumptions, which means the substance which are we going to use to depleting the ozone layer. So this was, the graphs were surveyed by NASA European Environment Agency in the year of 2015. So I think you have raised one doubt. Why we use the sustainable energies and what is the importance of sustainable energy? So let's clarify your doubt. So the sustainable energies provide a key benefits to us. So some of their environmental, it will be used for future generation and also energy efficiency. So let's we discuss what are there. So it will be sustainable energies provides key benefits to us. So it will be deal with the environmental conditions and also it can be serves or conserve the fossil fuels. And it can be reduce some of the pollution. So that's why we are going to use sustainable energy. Are you clarify your doubt? Yes. So let's remove some of the renewable resources. Are you observing that graph? From 1998, they used just 2% of the renewable resources. So they came to know what is the importance of using that sustainable energy. So nowadays they are going to use 23.7% of the renewable resources. So here's observing, are you observing the tables? Yes, Varo, there are some of the renewable resources and also emerging renewable resources. From that renewable resources, we are going to emerging the some of the, it produce a large amount of energy. So that's why we are going to use some of the energies like merit energy. So some of the renewable energies are solar, wind, hydropower, bioenergy and biomass and geothermal. These are the some of the renewable resources are going to be produced large amount of energy. So those are emerging renewable resources. So let's we check what is the percentage of the renewable resource. See, are you observing that graphs? So there are two pie charts. So the pie charts indicating some of the percentage. So let's we know what are the percentage. So the fossil fuels and nuclear powers contain 76.3% and also renewable resources contain 23.7%. So in the 23.7% we are taking as 100%. So the hydropower contains 16.6%, wind contain 3.7% and bio contain 2%. So these are some of the percentage which contain the renewable resource. So and also these supplies, the sustainable energy also can supply the technology. Then how we see that? So the renewable resources also can it is a continuous process. It will be used for our future generation also. So our forecaster said that it can be used in 100 megawatts. And so when the sustainable are going to use, some of the renewable resources are there. So let's be check what are the renewable resources. So there are hydropower, wind power, solar power, geothermal and biomass. So these are the some of the powers and some of the energies which are going to produce the electricity. So how the electricity comes from, let's we know one by one how the these powers are going to be produced the electricity. So let's we know what is the process of hydropower. So the hydropower which means it will be producing by the water is nothing but a hydropower. So in our past 50 years they use just 340 megawatts, and in 1950 they use 1500 megawatts. So in 2005 they are going to use, they are used 2994. So like this the hydropower will be increasing year by year. So let's see the diagram. Are you observing that diagram? Can you say what is that? So yes, Varos, those are, that is the large dam which was on Parana river. This is the Itaipu dam, large and biggest on the world. So it will be both, it will be jointly constructed by Brazil and Paraguay. And also this is the large scale producing in a terawatts. And are you clarify your doubt? So let's see what is the usage of from ancient days to still present days. So let's see that. Are you observing that graph? From 1972 to 2016, the usage of hydropower is more. Isn't it, Sparrows? Yes. So from 1972 to 2016, the increasing levels of the hydropower usage, it will be more. So that's why we can confirm that what is the importance of sustainable energy. So let's we know another resource, that is wind power. So that is wind power. Wind power, this wind power is nothing but generally the we know that some of the winds are occurred by doing by that winds also we can produce the electricity. So you are observing that winds, yes, that windmills are going to produce the electricity by some of these. Main concept is some of the turbines are going to produce the electricity. So by using that turbines also, we have some of the advantages and some of the disadvantages. So let's we know what are the advantages of using this wind power. So it is a pollution free. Yes, by that's why we are going to use these wind powers. And also it can be reduced the fossil fuels usage. So that's why we are going to use these types of sustainable energy. And also by using that wind power also, we have some of the disadvantages. So let's we know what are the disadvantages of wind power. So the disadvantages are, it can be polluted and it can be spoil the environment, and also it makes noise when the turbines are going to be rotated. So let's we see what is the usage from ancient days to still now recent year. So let's we check by the bar graph. Are you observing that, Sparrows? From 1995 to 2016, the levels will be increasing year by year. Are you observing that? Because it is a sustainable energy. So that's why we are going to use those types of energies to produce, to reduce the some of the pollution. And let's we know what are, let's we know another resource, that is solar power. Solar power. The solar power is generally known as, it will be produced the energy from the sun in the form of solar radiation. It is nothing but a solar power. So the solar power first started in the year of 1990. It is Japan. So it produced large amount of, it will be produced large amount of hydro solar power because it is an sustainable energy. So that's why it produced large in scale. So this was also followed by the Germany. So generally we are trapping the sunlight to produce the energy. So that's why it will be followed by Germany also. Let's we see the what are the usage of this solar power from ancient days to still our recent years. Are you observing that from 1996 to 2016 the increasing levels are very rapidly, because it is and just we are trapping the sunlight, just we are trapping the energy from the sunlight. So that's why the increasing levels are will be rapidly. And let's we check what are the advantages and what are the disadvantages. So by using that solar power we have some of the advantages and some of the disadvantages. So let's we describe what are the advantages using this solar energy. So By using that solar energy, we have materials. For that materials, we can traps the sunlight to produce the energy. So it can be does not produce the greenhouse gases. So that is the disadvantages of using that solar power. And also some of the disadvantage is to produce that energy, we want some materials. For that materials, it needs some of the cars. So that's why this is the one of the negative point using of that solar power. Are you understand? Yes. So let's remove another resource, that is geothermal. So that is geothermal. Geothermal is in the form of thermal energy generated by store within the earth, and also it can be used for our further history like bathing, heating and cooking. So to generate this energy, we can have above 400 degrees Celsius across the core. And also it is an excellent fuel. It is an excellent, because are you think why it is excellent energy? Because it will be available for 24 hours throughout the year. While comparing to the solar and wind, so it is an excellent energy while comparing to solar and wind. So let's we check what are the usage of from ancient days to still our recent years. Are you observing that graph? From 1982 to 2016, the increasing level of the geothermal will be increased, because it can be available for 24 hours. Just we are generating the electricity from the underground, so that's why it is a good electricity while comparing to the solar and wind. And it can does not, and by uses of average geothermal energy, it produces 122 kgs of CO2 per every year. And also when we are using some of the coal of the these geothermal, it produces 1/8 of the emissions to our 1/8 of the CO2 levels for our atmosphere. So these are some of the concept for that geothermal. Are you observing that? Yes. So let's we move another resource, that is biomass. You know that biomass. The biomass is generally known as, that is the common name for organic waste, which will produce it from the animals' dung and plants' waste, kitchen waste. These are the some of the organic waste which are going to produce the some of the energy. So in our India, in the year of 2017, they primarily produce 5% of the biomass. And also of that biomass, about 47% of the energy comes from the ethanol, and also 44% from the derived of the wood, and also 10% from the municipal waste. So by collecting these percentage, which we are going to producing the electricity. So by using these biomass also, we have some of the advantages and some of the disadvantages. So let's we describe what are the advantages and what are the disadvantages. So the advantages are, the biomass are reduce the fossil fuels, and also it can produce some of the heat and some of the steams. By using that heat and steams, we can use it for our residential purpose, and also agriculture purpose, and also industrial purpose. So these are, we are going to use by that biomass energy. And let's we describe what are the disadvantages of using this biomass energy. And also it may be, it sometimes it will produce some of the pollution to our environment. So this is one of the disadvantages of using that biomass. And also, what shall we describe about the usage of from ancient days to still now recent years? Yes, Varo, see that graph. From 1981 to 2015, the increasing of the usage of biomass will be increasing rapidly, because just we are collecting the energy from the organic waste by convert them into some of the energy and will use for our day-to-day life. So these are the some of the advantages and disadvantages and the usage of biomass in our day-to-day life. Are you observing that? Okay, are you understand? Are you getting my point? Yes. So let's we move another new energies, that is marine energies. You know that marine energy. The marine energy is generally known as the ocean energy. In our world, it will be covered 3/4 of the world, and it can be used some of the technicals and have tested that technicals and practice to extract the energies from the oceans, which are from oceans. So those technicals are wave energy, tidal energy, and some of the temperature gradient. So let's see that graph. 2001 to 2006 2015, the increasing of the marine energy is rapidly increasing because it is just comes from the waves and tides. So that's why the increasing levels of the marine energy will rapidly year by year. So let's we know what is the usage of that wave energies. So have a look at that wave energy. Are you observing that picture? So like that we are going to construct that wave energy on the oceans. So that oceans of the portion of the winds are kinetic and it can be converted into kinetic energy to transform into the water and it will be generate the electricity. So this is the process of wave energy. The advantages of these wave energies are it can capable of high efficiency of 60 to 80% of the capability to deal with the conditions, and also it does not produce the greenhouse gases. So these are the some of the advantages by using that wave energy. And let's we know what are the disadvantages by using this wave energy. The disadvantages are if you place that wave energy improperly, it will be damage the ecosystem. So this is the one of the negative point using that wave energy. And let's we see another disadvantage, that is maybe it will be release some of the pollutions to our marine ecosystem. So it will be difficult for living conditions to our aquatic life. So these are the two key disadvantages of using that wave energy. Are you understand? Yes. So these are the some of the advantages and some of the disadvantages using the wave energy. And let's we move another energy, that is tidal energy. Are you observing that picture? So like that we are going to construct the tidal energy under the oceans. So the tidal power, also known as the tidal energy, is a form of hydropower that converts into a energy into a useful waves, useful tides, mainly electricity. So by using that tidal energy also, we have some of the advantages and some of the disadvantages. So let's we describe what are the advantages and what are the disadvantages. So the advantages are it is an inexhaustible source, and also it can be does not produce a greenhouse gases. So these are the advantages of using that tidal energy. And also some of the disadvantages are to construct that power plant of the tidal energy, we need some of the material. So that materials are more expensive. So these are some of the disadvantages. And also it can be placed at a specific place like a coastal region. So these are the some of the disadvantages of using that tidal energy. Are you understand? So I want to give total overall conclusion about this. By using that those substances energies, it is the best source and this is the best energies for using, and it can be conserved the fossil fuels, and it can be reduce some of the pollutions like land pollution, water pollution, air pollution, noise pollution. To reduce all this pollution, we are going sustainable energy. We are using sustainable energy. These sustainable energies can conserve the fossil fuels and does not emitted the greenhouse gases, and also reduce the some of the pollution. And also nowadays these energies are going to be perform the electricity. And my question is, in previous my question is that all the works are done by the energy. So those are these energies. So these are the good energies to producing the electricity in a nature in a natural way, which are in our environment. So it does not harms the environment. It is based on our uses. Those disadvantages are, so it is an excellent energies to producing the energy, to producing the electricity from natural in the natural way. So I'll thank you to my Saraswati Madam Garu, and also so are you understand what are the resources? So the resources are hydroelectricity, biomass, geothermal, wave energy, tidal energy. These are some of the energies which are going to perform the electricity in a natural way. So these are some of the energies. So by using this energy, the pollution will be reduced. Are you think that? I'll show that another graph. In 2001 to 2010, the increasing of the sea water level will be increased rapidly. Can you think that after 2020, how the sea water levels were? For reducing that sea water levels, we are going to use sustainable energy. So the sustainable energy is the good solution for reducing all these such kind of solution to such kind of pollution. So it is a good solution, and also it will be increasing year by year because they came to know what is the importance of using that sustainable energies. And also this sustainable energy provide a key benefits to us, but not will harm our futures, and it can be used for our future generation also. It is a conserving energies which we can give to our future generation also. It is not a dissolving energy. So this is a good solution which are in our nature, comes from the naturally in our environment. By the environment only we can go into perform and conducting the electricity in a natural way. So are you understand? Okay. So our previous, they going to perform the electricity by the timbers. By that timbers and wood charcoal, some of the emission will be polluted to our surroundings, to our atmosphere. So it will be cast to greenhouse gases, and also it will be polluted. It will be increasing of the global warming. To reduce that global warming increase, we are going to use sustainable energy. So this sustainable energies are key benefits to us, which are in our environment, and also it can be reduce some of the pollutions, and it conserve the fossil fuels. And the disadvantages of these energies, are you thinking that why you are saying like some of the advantages and some of the disadvantages? The disadvantages is based on our usage. So those are the some of the disadvantages, and also the sustainable energy, which means is nothing but a, it can rapidly increasing, and it not a dissolving state. It can be used again and again. It is not a dissolving state and it not be extinct position, which we can use further and further. So that's why the sustainable came into the picture. So I'll thank you to my principal madam garu, Saraswati madam garu, and also I'll thank you to my mental teachers Rajamani madam garu and Ramakrishna madam garu, and also I'll thank you to my beloved secretary Praveen Kumar sir garu, which had given opportunity to tell this super student competitions. Okay, thank you.